Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we're going to be talking about some new books out for September. Now, I know I just did a list like this. I feel like I just did a list like this, but I also mentioned there's a lot of books coming out for October, for Halloween. So, yes, the list is growing and growing, and there's going to be another video soon enough with more books, I'm sure. So for now, we have 9 books, 7 books, something like that, and a little update as well. The 2 parts of the interview I did with Axel Barnes at the Typical Books podcast is now up and available. Both parts are there. And if you're interested in hearing the full interview every time before everyone else, you can check out my Patreon at patreon.com/typicalbooks. And speaking of books, I received some promotional copies of Augmented Classics. They've done 5 or 6 different horror classics, gothic classics. Right now I have The Phantom of the Opera and The Picture of Dorian Gray. You may recognize my name in the first few pages. A lot of the reviews and blurbs and promotional copy came from a lot of BookTubers and other book bloggers. So definitely check this out if you're interested. I will do a dedicated video on this shortly once all of the books are in everyone's hands. For a tail end of newsy updates, Prelight Eve 3 is coming out soon. I'm finishing the paginating right now and I'm debating putting up a sneak peek of the cover. I have released a little sneak peek to my newsletter readers already, so I'm debating putting it up here. I shouldn't be so shy about it. Speaking of new books, here are some new releases from Horror Writers Association authors. Now, as ever, these are books that are out and they are HWA authors. Of course, I curate the new releases page at the Horror Writers website at horror.org, so you can go check that out. And I also have a huge list of books coming out at Typical Books under New Horror. So we're gonna start with some stuff that's been out for a bit. It just hit the list now, but it's been out. The Headless Boy by Kelli, Owen. And I love this cover. Half of the time I complain about these sorts of covers because I'm like, oh, those creases need to be earned. People need to love those books. This hasn't been loved yet, but maybe it will be. I don't know. Who am I to judge? The cover looks really cool. So yeah, Kelli Owen. This is out by Poltergeist Press, and it came out in March. Reeling from the loss of a child, Maggie finds her job at the local daycare unbearable and errands around town impossible. Jake wants only the best for his broken wife, and a change of scenery makes perfect sense. A new home, a fresh start. But once they've settled in, Maggie offers him an alternative. And though Jake doesn't believe in ghosts, he plays along with the charade in the name of helping his wife, until he discovers it's not a game. Fantastic summary, really intriguing. It's the sort of storyline I'm not typically interested in, but I'm very interested in this charade. The Condemned by Jesse Rosenbaum, and this comes from Fulton Books. It came out in April. Michael has endless strings of nightmares that horrify and push him to the brink. With each passing dream, he gets closer to the dark figure who has brought him these horrific dreamscapes, unraveling the mystery of his role in this dark figure's designs. Interesting stuff. Also interesting is the cover of this. I thought it was a bat and I realized it was an elephant, and then I got very terrified because it reminds me of a demon. The Book of the Baku by R.L. Boyle. This is out from Titan Books, and it is out already. Sean hasn't spoken a word since he was put into care. When he is sent to live with his granddad, a retired author and total stranger, Sean suddenly finds himself reading a collection of stories that his granddad wrote about a Baku creature that eats the nightmares of children. The Baku tears free from the pages of the book and begins to stalk Sean, who has to find out how to defeat the creature in order to save himself and his granddad. I like that. It sounds like a more sophisticated version of the Babadook or something. So yeah, very interesting stuff. I do like the feasting on nightmares of children. Out last month, This Morbid Life by Loren Rhoads. This comes from Automatism Press. What others have called an obsession with death is really a desperate romance with life. Guided by curiosity, compassion, and a totally strange sense of humor, this particular Morbid Life is detailed through a death-positive collection of 45 confessional essays. You may remember Loren Rhoads from 199 Cemeteries You Must Visit Before You Die, or similarly titled work. Along the way, author Loren Rhoads takes prom pictures in a cemetery, spends a couple days in a cadaver lab, eats bugs, survives the AIDS pandemic, chases ghosts, and publishes a little magazine called Morbid Curiosity. I know I have morbid curiosity, so I'm very curious about this book. The Scrolls of Sin by David Rose. This is out already and it comes from the Wizard's Tower, which doesn't sound like a publishing house. It sounds like it literally comes from a wizard's tower, which I can get behind. A horror fantasy collection that follows the rise and fall of the white hot ambitious. From necromancers to sportive ghouls to conquering warlords to necromancers again, the Scrolls of Sin drips with human frailty and obsession in a dark, opulent other world. So a collection. Exploring Dark Fiction number 6, a primer to Ramsey Campbell. You may have noticed this has become the Ramsey Campbell channel, even though I can't really read a lot of Ramsey Campbell, which is just awkward for me. But here we are with a Ramsey Campbell Appreciation Day 12. This is edited by Eric J. Guignard and includes short fiction authored by Ramsey Campbell. Comes from Dark Moon Books. It is out this week. Dark Moon Books author and editor Eric J. Guignard presents this introduction to the work of Ramsey Campbell. It is number 6 in a series of scholarly primers exploring modern masters of short dark horror, with commentary by Michael Arnson, PhD, and beautifully illustrated by artist Michelle Prebich. Discover the vast and fantastic writing of Ramsey Campbell, and this may be up my alley. A couple more, and I'm very compelled to read this. I've seen it going around for quite some time. It's the cover that doesn't really grab me. It may grab you. I mean, it looks like it grabbed a lot of stuff. But here we are with Gorefest, Extreme Horror Anthology, edited by K. Trap Jones, and this comes from Evil Cookie Publishing. It is out now. 14 authors carve their path through the muck and grime to celebrate the art of gore. The following stories grip and grind through a labyrinth of demented deception, of unflinching and often humorous betrayals of society. The only thing for sure is that after each encounter, only a stain remains. Which is compelling to me. You know me, I like that stuff, but that cover, I don't know, I have an aversion, if you will, to Bizarro. And it just smacks of that. But I like the names of the authors that are in this. I mean, give me more Rath James White, right? So yes, I am very interested. When Darkness Finds You by Chris Cooper. This comes from Dreadful Media and it's out already. Along a busy street sits a house forgotten with time. To those who see its crumbling exterior peeking out from behind overgrown hedgerows, Auburn House is dead and decaying. But the house is very much alive. And underneath its dripping ceilings and within its cracked plaster walls lives a dark presence that's eager to make new friends. And no amount of fresh paint can cover up the evil inside. They have not mentioned one person in that synopsis, and I, for one, enjoy that. I want to read about a house. I was listening to a podcast talking about a story written from the viewpoint of a house that is still being written, I think, if it's not being shopped right now, so I'm reluctant to say who's writing it, but it is exactly what I want to read, you know, right now. I really love haunted house stories. I'm tired of the people being planted in these haunted houses, I guess. I want to read more of the haunted house and I want the house to be a character. So I don't know, maybe When Darkness Finds You will be that book. And last for today, The Deer King by Wendy N. Wagner from Journal Stone Books, and this is out right now. When a group of underprivileged teens are tormented by a sadistic drug dealer, they summon a supernatural being to protect them. Like you do. Now as adults unwillingly returning to their hometown, the friends discover their creation is being worshipped as a god, complete with blood sacrifice. And what sacrifice could be more powerful than God's own creators? Wow, that premise reminds me of like silly little things that parents might tell their kids to quiet them, and then 10 years later the kid comes back at them with that fact they were told, and the parents are just like, what? Oh, that? Oh, I made that up. In a really exploded fashion. And I'm very interested in this demon god creature they summoned. So that's it for new books that are out right now. In the next list of books, there are more Halloweeny titles. So in the next week or two, I'm going to have another video coming up with more new releases, and I suspect I'll be doing a video like this every 2 weeks at the very least, talking about new books coming until we're into November. So If there's any of those books that you've already read, let me know in the comments below. I'm very interested in the Kelli Owen book, actually. That's the one that sticks out the most to me. And then When Darkness Finds You, The Auburn House just sounds delicious in so many ways. So yeah, let me know if you've read those or if there's any of those that you're definitely adding to your reading list right now. Thank you again for watching and have an ooky, spooky day.